Hey, I'm Michael, and I play guitar.
Hey, I'm Mike, I play bass.
I'm Sam, I sing.
I'm John, I play keyboard.
I'm Anthony, and I play drums.
Well, John and I were friends, and we moved to New York from upstate New York in around like 2002, 2003. We all just kind of met in the city, just like making music and stuff like that. And John and I started writing these songs together, and we would go out to these underground dance clubs in the city. We started hearing this electronic music that was coming out of there. It sounded like real lo-fi electronic stuff, and we really liked that. We thought it would be cool if we could incorporate that with lo-fi rock and roll kind of sound. So we started writing the songs, we met these guys, started playing live, and that's kind of how it all started.
We actually did the whole first record, you know, entirely in our apartments, you know, self-produced, just on an iMac. So it was a really cheap album to make and pretty different than our second one.
Well, we wanted to do stuff with the second record that we weren't able to do with the first one. We wanted to use new sounds, new textures, and we record it like a rock song. But then at that point, we put it in the computer and like remix it. So it's kind of like we make rock songs the way that DJs make music.
The old stuff, it was like dance party and fast and just go out and tear it up. This is, you know, there are mid-tempo songs, slower songs.
We talked a lot about instruments that we liked and put it all in the studio in Atlanta and kind of like painted over the windows and just like locked ourselves in for a few months and grew beards and just like didn't talk to anyone and just mess around with all this stuff. When I look at the collection of songs now, there's definitely the darkest stuff that I've ever written on it, but also the most hopeful, optimistic stuff. That's why the album's called like The Sun and the Moon. It reflects those extremes, and there's even sort of a spiritual aspect to it, like, you know, what is beyond life and that kind of thing. Writing songs gives you a chance to express thoughts that you wouldn't normally talk about to people and get that out. So yeah, I think it is very cathartic.
Videos are just so much fun to make, so why wouldn't you just take advantage of it and just do the craziest thing you can think of?
Just try to come up with like a really simple visual concept, like something you could say in one sentence. Like, did you see the video with the dominoes? Or the video with the speedboats.
Played acoustic this morning. We did our new single Time, and it was the first time I ever really heard the lyrics. Whenever I look back on the best days of my life. In kind of a more sullen way, because musically when you hear it, you know, in a normal production, it's, you know, it's really kind of cheery and you could almost miss, you know, how melancholy a lot of the lyrics are. I heard it this morning and it was just a total different take on it.
Any of you guys read the lyrics today for the first time?
I wept.
Did you actually cry? Wow. Brought to tears. We were doing a photo shoot, and we were playing cards, just sort of horsing around, and Anthony was like, "What? You know, why don't we do something with cards for the video?" And then I was like, what if you build a card house, but then you like, lived in the card house? And so you had, like, a whole card universe, and it related to the song, because the song is about missing out on life. So we had to get a card house builder. The weirdest thing, to me anyway, is that the stuff he makes is so sturdy that you can't knock it over. Actually, three people died in the shooting of our video. It's sad, but it is worth it, though. Have you said anything yet?
I said my name.